I found this fantastic footage on Reddit.com. Just to set the scene, it's a man in a subway. Here we go.
That's great. Things happen.
I got her too.
I have.
Hold on. Don't ignore him. I have freedom. I have rights. Serve the people.
I have the right to not
get it. Yeah, but you have your rights. I'm not forcing you. You're forcing me.
Sir,
I am free.
I'm
going to have to call.
Call who you need to, but I'm just saying, it's the law with the health department.
No, it's not. You're breaking the law. You're following them. I'm not.
Sir?
I have free.
Okay.
Serve my sandwich.
I don't need to serve.
Yes, you do.
He was very upset.
The guy walks into a subway, not wearing a mask. Obviously, he's a no-masker, I would imagine.
Yeah.
And he demands to have a sandwich, and the woman
sounds like a number two, I think.
Yeah.
That's probably one of their classic value sandwiches.
Nice.
Because those are the first couple on the menu.
Okay. Fantastic, James. I love your knowledge of the subway menu. It's really helping out the show. Really, really great.
Every episode, I've got a subway fact.
And so... the woman behind the counter is like a very sweet person, obviously, and she's doing great. And she's like, hey, sir, policy says we can't serve you. Does he have a right to be served a sandwich from a privately owned business?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
Subway can discriminate for every reason except for like five.
Okay.
Yeah.
Name the five.
Race, religion, national origin, some sex, and something else.
It's a very specific set
of civil rights
protected classes, right? No, he has no right to a Subway sandwich unless they're, like, specifically kicking him out because he's...
If the guy was not being served because he was black or because he was Jewish or something, then the Subway would be in a problem.
I think it would also be if he has a disability.
Disability, that's on ADA also.
Gotcha.
And that's where this gets a little dicey because people are saying that it's like, oh, I have a disability, so I can't wear a mask.
Yeah.
You would have to be a well-founded claim of disability, like something that a doctor could diagnose you with.
A lot of people say, well, I have asthma, so I can't wear a mask. I have asthma. I wear a mask.
You can breathe through
all the time.
You can breathe with a mask.
Now I'm not wearing a mask right now because I'm in my bubble.
Yeah.
But,
it'd be weirdly weird if people couldn't breathe in a mask because people would just be like dropping like flies everywhere. Clearly you can breathe with a mask.
So
What if he has one of those laminated pieces of paper that says, I am a member of the No Mask Society and I'll sue you if you...
Bring it on.
Yes. I was like, are you sure? Like,
bring
the filing
it on.
Fee is... I don't even think you could make... You could get that lawsuit dismissed pretty quickly. But if that cost you more money than getting a mask or a sub...
If you're suing Subway, that's not like the individual franchise owner that's getting sued.
You're suing Subway.
So with those cards, with those cards, it says you...
I'm not suing the customer. No, I'm saying the customer's
But then I'm going to respond to get attorney
feedback. I'm
not going
to sue some jag with one of those cards.
I want attorney's fees from the customer who's making that.
Oh, for sure.
I will own his house.
So those cards specifically say that you, the employee, are liable in this situation. And the individual employee, the Target employee or the Subway employee in this situation, the nice woman who's like, hey, sir, I can't serve you. She personally, not Subway, but she is liable.
She's not liable.
Illegal for you to talk to me while making eye contact. And if you talk to me while making eye contact, you are liable.
I will sue you.
Yeah.
Okay. That's about the same
legal.
That's
what that card is. I just did there, that's that card.
I love
that. You can't
that.
Just make shit up. Just because it's laminated doesn't mean it's true.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Yes.
Anybody can laminate whatever they want.
I'll extend that all to all cease and desist letters. When someone sends you a cease and desist letter,
do whatever.
It is not binding.
And here's a free pro tip for all the listeners. If you get a cease and desist letter and it has an attorney listed, do not call the number on the letter. You need to look the attorney up online.
Yeah.
Find their official website. And call that number.
Yeah. And then be like, hey, like, I got
Did you
letter.
Actually send this?
Yeah. Or is this a load of shit?
Yes.
And if they said, yes, we sent it, hang up, don't talk to them, keep carrying on.
Guys, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, make sure you like it. Post a comment with your thoughts. We'd love to hear what you're thinking and jump in the comments, have a little argument with you. If you want to argue with us, that'd be great. Also, if you could share this video, if it resonated with you and you think it could help other people, that would be fantastic. Guys, if you would like a will, estate plan, or just about anything else regarding end-of-life legacy preservation, give us a call at 404-939-7562 or send us an email. It is info@modernestateplanning.com or post a comment and we will help you there too. Guys, thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.